Hey guys, this is the Gaming Robot, and I want to welcome you back once again to the Birch Forest Rally. It's been a month, probably, and yeah, today we are on location in what looks to be the middle of nowhere, but it is a loop, which usually means something, and that it does, because we are at a loop facing, well, the Black Fire is facing towards the British Terminus. Here we go, this. We are in the loop, and Dockside is that way, and Village Terminus is that way. And the reason this loop is built is because, due to poor fleet work and general placing of track poorly by me, I decided to create a completely different and new way to get to the docks, which I've also done a remap of. If you remember in the last video, I took the newly released BR Class 15, in VR green all the way down to Dockside, or Docklands, I haven't yet decided, to fix the mess that was. And I have, I've just focused more on the docks and a lot of terraforming. If you do keep up with the series, you'll probably notice a difference, but if not, don't worry, this is just a video of me driving the train from a certain place to another certain place. And said train today will be 45110 or 110 Black 5, which is made by Dank _ London. That's the modeler's name. His Discord name is something different. And yeah, this comes from, once again, the Immersive Railroading Discord community. It's not a showcase, I haven't been asked to, but I am just going to credit the modeler because I feel that's right and, you know, just a generally nice thing to do. But anyway, in the real life counterpart, 45110, resides at the Barrow Hill Roundhouse, which is Britain's historic roundhouse. It's like the only roundhouse in Britain. And still functional today. It's a working museum, and it has a mainline connection. It does a lot of servicing of the gears and such. But anywho, once again, I am unnecessarily rambling, so we'll do what we usually do, and we'll ramble on. So, yeah, the loco looks really good. I really do like the rotting details, and the little cab details are quite cool, and the fact that the coal's like sparsely covered, well, that might be a visual glitch. Run the full tenders work. So yeah, let's wind the reverser. This is the reverser. Let's wind the reverser in full reverse, surprisingly. Take off the brakes and open up the regulator. Signal the whistle, which is a custom one, which is great so that I don't have to deal with the hooters. Slightly annoying, especially on something like the Ivert, I suppose. Because most British locos usually have chime whistles, which are like higher pitch whistles, and then the common American steam locomotive or other continental steam locomotives will usually have lower pitch whistles or horns, essentially. They're called hooters. I don't know what you call them. I'm not familiar with American locos as much as I am with British locos. And speaking of being familiar with British locos, the Black 5 was a general loco, so it could be doing stopping services, express trains, heavy freight, mixed goods, trip freight, light engine movements. So this is all a new track here, and as the generation of diesels came about, the loco was mainly probably put on heavy freight, but this loco, in terms of like tender driven locos, aside from all of the famous named locos, these kind of locos are most common on preserved railways, and as I said before, this one, or this particular numbered one, resides on Barrow Hill Roundhouse Railway thing. Anywho, we are approaching the docks, so we're going to lower some speed, and we're going to whistle, because I like to whistle, but it's also to signal that we are here, we have arrived, ready to collect the train, which is hopefully going to connect, which is just my second time recording this. I ran into a technical error on the last recording, I just didn't have the right resource packs there, so I had to cover those. Ooh, this is going to be rough. I am a realistic driver, capable of driving. Yeah, I think I got it. It didn't make a couple of noise, but that's because I got the back instruction mode. So hopefully, as soon as I do this, you can then see that that is all coupled. And to segue, let's just check what we've got. We've got 6 fish wagons or box vans full of fish. Some flatbeds full of nothing. I have miscounted. We have 5 instead of 6. Whoops. Which is fine. I'm sure it'll be fine. I'm not going to panic or anything. My OCD isn't kicking in or anything. And we have 6 14-ton tank wagons. And as far as I'm aware, and I'm just going to check just so that I don't get it wrong, the 14-ton tanker wagon is made by the know-it-all who made... Boco Productions, who made the Ivert and the 4F, which are currently over there, as well as the flatbeds, I think, as well. He made the flatbeds. And the box vans come from the Midland Railway texture pack, which is made by, and I just feel the need to credit, I think it's made by Dragon. I'm not sure. If necessary, I will look after the video and check. I'm also being a very professional YouTuber here. But no, welcome to the docks, where everything is rather skeletal. I've done like 3 days worth of work in this area. I mean, half a day, because I tend to sleep in when there's nothing to do. And you'll see that there are a few new locos, these two specifically. And they'll come later down the line as I review them. Why are there 2 4Fs? What is going on there? I'm confused. Okay. I know why now. I'm gonna ignore it. Professional YouTuber. Anywho, rather than look at all my bolts and be worried and get incredibly over the top of the OCD, there's an OH chunk down there, which is just our regular shunter. And this is a rather fun shunting puzzle. I am all over the place today. Let us get on the move, hopefully with a full train of, I believe it is now 17 or 15 wagons, including the GWR tote, which should hopefully all be connected. Let's use the nice custom whistle sound, which is looping, but still good. And let us pull away with a rather heavy freight, hopefully, from taking everything. Yep, looks like it. Nothing's trailing off the back. Okay, slightly worried. Yeah, I'm just checking the brake band. Should be there. Okay, looks like we're good. I'm not sure whether to stop in the loop and then do another startup, but because that's on a hill, I feel like we should just charge the loop. Because we're now... Actually, no, we're going down the bank now, because we've already come up the bank, which is why I was doing so much speed. And now we're going down the bank. But, anywho, let's begin whole talky, rambly thing. So, like I said, I've done around about 3 days' worth of work in this general area. And I do have plans of what to do. I kind of want to put what if I'm once I'm able to get the track plan of dockside, dockland, station done correctly, then or done to a way that's satisfactory to my standards. I also want to put in a general motive depot, so that serves DMUs, HSTs, which are some of the new diesel locomotives that have come out recently, Class 66, 37s, and the BFR. And then I want to have the steam. Oops. Buttons. Wow, this is not supposed to go this fast. We'll break. Even though we're going down the bank, we're still going to break. Yep, got everything. Okay. And yeah, that's basically what I want to do with Dockside. We have got to break all the way because we're flying all the points. Idiotic, realistic driver. That's me. Anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, I want a general motive stepo, if possible, just so that I can have a good mixture of steam and diesel, steam and diesel on the line. And the way that I think I can do it is from dockside lands to village terminus is all mainline stuff. So the predominant stuff of today and a little bit further backwards, so that I can include the class 101 DMU in BR, blue, and white. And then have from village terminus to Land's End all the heritage, so that will have steam and older generation diesels. Because I do want to run the class 43 HST among many other locos of interest, which will come in the future eventually. And I also, on top of uploading like the regular series, which I think this is, I also want to upload some more like random content, stuff like VR chat or GTA 5, Toge Racing. Ooh, dear. That's Little Witches. Stuff like that, just so that I can not feel like I'm restricted to one form of content, which is why I put out all of the OBS benchmark videos. Just to see how that would go down. And it's gone down not as well as the Minecraft stuff, because I actually go out of my way to promote that on the Discords and in some forms of social media, if I exist on those. But it has gone down relatively well. There have been some consistent views, consecutive views, new subscribers. If anyone is a new subscriber here, welcome to the channel. Things will get random, but things will hopefully be fun. Anywho, I just want to be able to upload content regularly, even if it's not like Minecraft related. Most of the stuff will probably end up being Minecraft related, but it would just be nice to, you know, upload random stuff, benchmark recordings, some editing, which I do plan to do. For example, if you haven't seen it, Toge Attack was my attempt, shall we say, at playing around with the Rockstar editor. I think I did okay. I mean, it's not as good as those who would do like a full 20 or 10 minute movie length. This could be 20 minutes worth of, you know, really good Rockstar or GTA footage. Then congratulations, because that is a task in and of itself. And if you're also doing other editing on top of that, then that is just great as well. But no, I only did like a minute's worth of footage, because that was just my test footage that I took. And the whole benchmark test was actually after that test footage that I took. So the Subaru, which I think it was a Subaru, it was probably an Evo. Everyone likes their four-wheel drive cars these days. I've already switched the point, so we should just be able to change back. The car that was shown in Toge Attack, that crashed out. That was the same car that crashed out in the 5M benchmark test. Anywho, I know that I've been rambling, but it's just that I'm either always talking about the railway or I'm always talking about myself, so, or my channel, or the channel in general. We are just crossing the loop at Village Terminus from platform 1 to 2, and then we're going to attempt to do a very interesting maneuver with the tow van. Or the toad, as my dad nicknames it for some reason. Whereas it's nicknamed in general. But yeah, the long and short of it is I want to be able to do some more content, just random content of interest. Anything that I feel is worth recording. And yeah, that's just basically it. And let's see what's going on. I had to change the points a little quicker than I wanted to. Okay. Brakes. Get out. Also, you may notice, aside from the now what will be the standard recording quality, and hopefully the mic's working nicely. I've taken off the pop filter because I realized just a little bit ago that the pop filter is mainly used for when you have the mic really close to your face, which I do not. It is like probably about 30 centimeters away from my mouth so that I can sit comfortably and play Minecraft or whatever games it is that I want to play at the time. Let's see. So this maneuver that I'm currently attempting to do would be prototypical within the days of British Steam, I believe. Because when I've usually done crate, I've had a breakdown at both ends, so I can just run around the train, it's a lot easier. But this just adds another layer of fun, I suppose, when you're operating your railways. Anyway, let's just gently attempt to couple up to the breakdown. Sinking to a faster step, and a bit of slap. There we go. Okay, good. Okay, so I should just be able to pull back, hopefully, with the toad in 12 toe. Yeah. But yeah, like I was saying, aside from the recording quality, which will now be standard so long as I have the desktop and so long as things don't go wrong, I have upgraded the immersive railroading mod, the .jar file, which is just what runs the mod, not the texture packs. I've upgraded that from 1.6 to 1.7, and the 1.7 was released last week, I think so, maybe Sunday, Monday, as of recording. And yeah, things are. It handles the entities, I think the locos and carriages count as entities, but it handles entities a lot better, because whenever we came in past videos, whenever we went into midpoint, entered village terminus, or basically any station that had rolling stock currently just sitting there, it would always lag as the chunks loaded, but then again we were on a laptop that was having something of a nightmare trying to run the game for us. And that laptop has been put to rest after serving me so well for 2 years, and you know, being the starting device for hopefully a rebirth of a YouTube channel. But yeah, updating it has caused some issues. I got lucky that nothing corrupted, but visual glitches such as jumping out of your, getting off the train loco that you're driving, and finding yourself stuck in the half slab, or at least within the class 66, there's some weird rendering issues around the screen for some reason, and as you saw as we were coming into Verge Terminus from the Dockside branch line, I'll just pull that back a bit so that I don't have to reverse so harsh. Just needs to be 40 degrees. That ought to do it. Okay. This wouldn't be prototypical. They would actually go fully into the loop, but I can't be bothered to do that because I've got no one spotting me. So if this goes wrong, which it might, things get difficult, right? Let's just back you up a bit. And if I can catch up with it, oh no, that's not good. No, got it. Back. Back. Okay, well, that didn't go as well as planned. Let's just professional YouTubering, and we'll just catch our train. We'll hard brake, test the brakes, and then I'm just gonna have to gently push it ahead of the blades. Hope that when I switch the points, nothing bad happens. I should have checked. I was going to, but I didn't, so it's my fault that time. Okay. As you can tell, I've only done this maneuver once. Let's just give it a gentle push. Nothing too much, too much, too much, too much. Please stop. Oh boy. Okay, did it stop? Is it stopping? No, it's not stopping. It's not stopping. It didn't stop. Well, welcome to the unseen life of a Minecraft YouTuber in a mod. Right, professional YouTuber. So it should be facing this way, we'll put it there. And click the points, and let's stop wasting time and get on with it. I'm now slightly annoyed. I think I pressed the button. Let me just check. I did not. Awesome. So that's happened, and that's a choke. I wasn't expecting it to go. Don't worry, we'll get it eventually. It just might take a while. Get to where we want to go, and we'll do stuff. And stuff will happen. And yeah, I'm annoyed at that. I knew I wasn't going to get it like on the first try, and I did it twice yesterday with a 66, and it didn't with the class 66, and it didn't go too badly. Right, so the blazer switched at that end, which is great, and the blades are just the points, by the way. If you get the wheels behind the blades when you switch the blades, it won't affect the wagon or anything. Okay, let's just check. You are now in normal mode. Where are you? You are in normal mode also, so hopefully I should hear a large clunk once I caught up to it. It would be nice to have like a whole shunting layout where I can literally just bank a load of wagons and just have them roll gently down the slope. Because that was a thing in the days of steam, which is like 1950s onwards, like in the golden era of steam, where you could go anywhere and see the sort of steam loco before they started taking stuff. I swear, I've been up for 2 hours. I should not be like this. Wow, this is terrible. Yeah, maybe it'd be easier for me to listen to the engine working. Get this done. Easy up, straight all the way. Okay, I need the points. I'm not sure about myself, but that doesn't matter. Here we go. We are literally, no pun intended, going off the rails here. We'll get there, we'll get to midpoint, and we'll shunt back, and I can finally say that this has been a video, a train wreck of a video, but a video nonetheless. Was able to get multiplayer working, then it would be a lot easier to record videos nonetheless, I do have a sort of plan. I have seen it being done, but usually when someone's train spotting in their own world, they've got loads of players running around and they're all driving trains, like a very small size, like the loco and three coaches because of the lag. But if I was smart enough, or smart as I appear, which is not very... I could use the replay mod, which does function well with 1.12.2, which is what we're playing on. I could use the replay mod, record footage of me pulling away from the station or doing a start from somewhere with a loco, go back into editing within the replay mod, and aside from the fact that the audio won't, once you've fully rendered the video of the edit, the audio won't be there, so I'm going to have to find a way, or would have to find a way, to overlay the audio sound on top of it. It could be possible that I would be able to do a train spot video of some kind, and I wouldn't be, it wouldn't just be like single 2-minute videos or something from a train pulling away from the station. If I used also Windows Movie Maker, I believe it's called, I can add clips on top of each other, so I can just do some general editing, which would, you know, improve the quality of the channel, which is something I'm always thinking about. I don't think I'm going to get that into the siding. Oh, this is gonna be fun. And wagons are glitching out of plenty. We can get it in the loop. And it is 5 coaches long. This is the loop. Okay. If it's fully in the loop, here's my thinking. If it's fully in the loop and there's enough for loco at one end, which there is, it should, in theory, I have to change that point. It should, in theory, go into... Did I change it? No, I haven't. Go into the sightings, which I have placed here, and then that should go along. Because these are about the same size as... Yeah, it should work. In theory, it should work. I am crossing everything possible right now. Okay. Let's begin the really... interesting and fun, so I'm getting around. Fun shunt backwards with a nice looking loco. You wouldn't be able to do this prototypically, there's probably rules to it. I should be honest, you would, so long as you had someone in the brake van, but we do not. And I am doing this all from driver's intuition, of which I have very little. And the wagons are glitching out again, which is worrying. She also restricts her speed, so that I'm going to go to the bypass or something. Just so that nothing goes out, and also be ready to hard brake, because that would probably be a very clever idea. Acceleration. Much acceleration. You are going round, aren't you? Yep, okay, that's the brake band going round, and then you'll go straight point-wise. Yep, oh no, that's the wrong way. Keep going, come on. I'm trying to save this video, then you change the points to that. Sorry, dude. Because I pulled in, so... No, that's a good thing. Regulator, which causes acceleration by releasing steam into the pistons, which pushes the rods, which pushes the wheels, and the steam comes from the boiler, and you have just learned in a really idiotic way how a steam worker works. Congrats. I just taught you that. If that's one thing to take away from this video, know that I have taught you how a steam worker works. Poorly, but I have taught you that. Okay. I think here's a good place to stop. Yep, looks like it. Okay, loco's in. Everything's in, and I have room to spare, don't I? Yeah, lots of room to spare. Oh, I was overreacting again. Anywho, we'll back the loco into the station, and then I'll probably wrap it up, and I apologize in advance for whatever this video has been. Hopefully it's been something entertaining. If not, then check out my other videos. Maybe those will be better than this one currently. I'm just vlogging my YouTube channel all over this video. But no, seriously, this has been, this has been what is relatively average of a standard YouTube video of mine where I have my voice in, which is usually why on other videos I choose to be mute, is then my awkwardness does not come across in the video. But no, seriously, I'll talk some more in a minute. Up. I should have taken a screenshot of the dogs, why didn't I? Damn it. Point. That rodding work is so good. Yeah, looks like we're starting there. Awesome. And I'll be putting the hard flag for soon. Okay. Let's do some stuff. There you go. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I don't know what it came out to be. Maybe it was good fun, maybe it wasn't. Hopefully everything worked well. The way I have the mic set is probably my biggest worry at the moment. But aside from that, providing everything goes well, this will end up becoming a video on YouTube, which is kind of the intention. But to go over the points that were stated, I do want to upload a lot of varied and mixed content just so it can become a gaming channel rather than a Minecraft-related channel. And all of the Minecraft stuff will still be here, and I'll be promoting that within the various Discord communities that take interest in it. And YouTube and its amazing algorithm will also do the same in pushing out those videos rather than others. But if you do want to see whatever sort of content I do, I'll probably leave a few videos here that you can check out. And yeah, like I said, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like. If this is something you want to see on a more regular basis, quote, quote, don't forget to subscribe, pick what video, whatever videos you want to watch. But if you are subscribed, then that helps me out greatly. Turn on the bell so that when I next upload a video, hopefully not like this, a little better than this, YouTube will hopefully notify you of that. And yeah, rambling aside and everything I said that I wanted to, anyway, I'll see you guys later. Bye.